we're looking at a page of 100 bullets flats, but there's a problem, and I'm going to zoom in and show you. As you can see, the edges of the flats are all anti-aliased, which is not what we want. This is going to cause problems when you use the wand tool to make selections. As you can see, the wand tool is not selecting right up to the edge of the flats. To fix this, we select the wand tool and turn off Apply to Connected Pixels Only. All of my selection tools are set to Add to Selection. This way I don't have to keep holding down the Shift key to keep adding to the selection. You want to make sure you select the middle of areas and not the edges. You don't want any of the anti-aliased areas. Popping into Quickmask mode is an easy way to see what areas I've missed. Now that I have everything selected but the anti-aliased areas, I invert my selection and delete to transparent. Now I'll show you the tool we use to close the gaps in all the transparent areas. We're going to use the correct line width brush under the correct line tools. I have it set to thicken and 8 pixels wide. As you can see, it fills in the transparent areas by spreading the colors from either side. The edges are completely aliased and crisp. You don't have to use a small brush to work on the whole page. That would be tedious and make it easy to miss spots. I can zoom out to see the whole page, make a huge brush, and do the whole thing all at once. You may want to do this a second time just to make sure you've got all the transparent areas on the page filled in properly. So that's how to fix anti-aliased flats in Clip Studio Paint. I'm Mark Sweeney. Thanks for watching.